Hey y'all, today I made throw pillows and it was super easy and no sewing was required, so thank the Lord for that. I will show you how I did it. First, you need to get some fabric, any color or pattern of your choosing. Next, a pillow insert or a pillow form, I don't really know what they're called. This was like $3 at Walmart. Fabric scissors or regular ones if you don't have fabric scissors. Fabric glue, this was the cheapest kind. And an iron. Now let's get started. First, iron your fabric. And even if you hate ironing, please don't skip this step because you don't have creases all over your pillow because it's not very attractive. And if you don't want to iron the whole piece of fabric, at least iron the part that you're going to use to make your pillow. And once you've finished ironing, fold it back in half, but try and do it lightly so you don't like crease it again and undo your ironing. And then cut around the pillow, but leave at least 2 or 2.5 inches on each side of it. Try and cut the line as straight as you can just to make it easier for yourself in the long run. And then once you finish, lay your fabric out, open it up, and then lay it out on a flat surface. I started with one of the short sides of my fabric, and it doesn't matter which side it is, but just take your glue and draw a line as close to the edge as you can get it and do a line. Do not do a zigzag or a squiggly line, do a straight line, because if it shows through the fabric at all, like depending how thin your fabric is, it's gonna look a lot better if it's just one line. And then fold it over, and if you miss any places, go ahead and go back in with the glue and make sure you have all the edges like pressed down well. I then repeated these steps of drawing the line and folding it over on the 2 longer sides. I didn't feel like doing the other short side because it's not going to be seen on the outside of the pillow and I didn't want to waste the glue, but you're welcome to do it if you want to, whatever your preference is. And when you're doing this, don't forget if you miss any spots, just go on back in and do it because better fix it now than have to fix it later. And you want to just make sure all the edges kind of look like they're hemmed or something like that and they're folded over so they're not like jagged and losing strings everywhere because that's not pretty. And once you finish all the edges, grab your pillow and you're going to put it in the middle of the fabric or maybe a little towards one side or the other, but mostly in the middle, and just lay it out so you can see how it's going to come together when you actually glue it. And it's kind of like a little practice round, I guess, to see how it's going to look. And before you start gluing anything, make sure your fabric is as tight as you can get it because you don't want it to like sag in the front of your pillow because that's not cute. And once you have everything pulled as tight as you can get it, grab your glue again and fold back the edge that looked like it was hemmed, I guess, and do a line of glue on that and then press it down very firmly. And I'm gonna fold the edges. You're welcome to do this however you want, but I'm just showing you how I did mine. I think it would also be cool to just kind of like glue the 2 pieces together, like the 2 flaps together. That could be cool too, but this is how I did mine. So then I put a line of glue, because I'm all about lines of glue today apparently, on the end flap right here. I only did one side of it because I don't want to glue the fabric to the pillow just in case I ever need to take it off. And then I folded down the corners first, and I kind of did 3 folds. I don't know if you saw how I did it before, but it was like fold in, then fold in again, and then fold 1 big flap over. And so once you folded it all over, press it firmly again, and then if there's anywhere that you need to touch up with some glue, go in and put some extra glue there, because better safe than sorry. And then add more glue to the other open side to close that one up. And once again, I only did like the bottom flap. I didn't do the top one because I don't want to glue the pillow to the fabric. And then I just folded it the same way that I folded it before and pressed it firmly on the top. And that's it, y'all. Literally easiest thing you'll ever do in your life. And there you go, you're finished. This was my final product, what all the seams and everything looked like. And yeah, it was really fun. I actually made 5 of them. I would love to make more, but I don't have anywhere to put them. So yeah, I hope you guys have fun making yours. And as always, thank you so much for watching.